Okay, everybody, welcome in here to this video. Today we are going to be taking a look here at the SpyPoint Solar Dark Trail Camera. So this is a solar powered trail camera. This is the first time I'm ever using one of these. I'm really excited to try it out. They give you the option, if you're worried about it running out of power, you can put AA batteries in it. So I think I'm going to do that just in case, but they say you shouldn't even need that. So I'm really excited about using a trail cam like this. The other cool thing is they give you a free SD card and a card reader. Another cool feature about this camera is the fast trigger speed. You can actually turn this up to a 7/100th of a second trigger speed. And according to SpyPoint, that is the fastest trigger speed in the entire trail cam industry. So if you guys are interested in this camera, I have the link for it down in the description below, and we're just going to take a look here at some of the features of this camera. So these are some of the features just on the box. If you guys are interested in learning more about it, I'm sure you could call SpyPoint, do some more research online and learn a lot more about it. But 12 megapixel pictures, 42 LEDs, built-in 2-inch viewing screen with zoom and pan functions, color photos by day, infrared by night, date, time, moon phase, and temperature stamp on the photos, which is always really nice. It does have a time-lapse mode, multi-shot mode, up to 6 photos per detection, which is actually quite a few. That's double compared to what most trail cams will do. Hybrid illumination, invisible optimal boost, blur reduction, detection technology, continuous mode, flash range up to 90 feet, and like I mentioned earlier, the millisecond trigger speed at 7/100th of a second. So right there she is. You can see about how big it is. Nothing too bulky there with the solar panel. So you got the latch here on the side. You just pop it there and there. That opens up. We'll open her up there. We'll just take off these screen protectors. Okay, so we got our strap, and then this is the charging cord. So what you're supposed to do is charge this for 24 to 48 hours before you put it out. Now, we obviously did the unboxing right here where we're gonna put it out. So we're gonna put batteries in it and just let it run off the batteries here to start. And then after we pull this, we'll charge it the next time so it can run off of the solar power. So we're just gonna throw the SD card in, flip it on. Now we're ready to start going through our settings and set this camera how we want it for this particular situation here on this deer trail that comes out into this little clearing. We'll just do 10 seconds. Wait, So you got this little bracket here that actually pops off if you need to take it off. And that's what holds it to the tree, and your strap just goes right through there. Comes right out the other side like that. Got it. So right about there, you wanna hold that, Hirsch?
Yep.
And I'll strap her down. Right there, facing right back at the trail. We've already got our settings the way we want them. So we're just gonna go here to start camera, hit okay, we're on photo, and it's gonna give you a countdown so you know you're gonna be getting pictures right after that so we can latch her up. And we're just gonna leave that for probably at least a couple weeks, get some pictures of some deer, who knows what else, and we'll take a look at the pictures and see how it does. Hey, what's up guys? Just wanted to kind of give you an update here on the SpyPoint and show you some of the trail camera pictures. We had that camera out at Brandon's parents' house where we set it up here in the first part of this video, and then I actually moved it up to my feeder at my cabin in North Central Pennsylvania, and we got some awesome pictures of some bear, some raccoons, turkeys, and some pretty sweet pictures of my target buck up there that I've been chasing for like 5 or 6 years now. We believe it to be either an 8.5 or 9.5 year old buck, and he's just an absolute monster. So let's take a look at some of these pictures. So first here we have a picture of a raccoon that I thought was pretty cool on top of the feeder there. Then we have two different bear at the feeder at the same time during daylight on the 16th. There's a doe during daylight. You can see pretty nice clear images during the day and at night, just like this one here. We got two doe at the feeder. There's a bear kind of standing up. That picture I thought was pretty cool, kind of looking back behind the camera. And here's a few doe during daylight again at the feeder. And then right here is the big guy. You can see real big buck. And here he's with two other buck. That's an 8-point and a 6-point that he's been hanging out with quite a bit. There's a couple raccoons there at the feeder too. Another angle of him there from the side. There's the 6-point. been really pleased with the picture quality here of this thing at night. There's the 8-point there right in front of the camera. A couple more shots of them. And then the last picture here is a pretty good looking bear. So just from the spy point being there at the feeder for a few weeks, I had like over a couple thousand pictures to go through. So those are just some of the ones that I picked out to show you guys. But like I said, real pleased with the image quality of this camera. Very easy to use, and I've pretty much liked everything about it so far. The biggest thing too for me is having a solar powered trail camera. I already know I have a spot picked out in mind that I want to put that thing for this fall in a place where I'm not going to be able to go to and check it very often. So with a typical trail camera, that's a spot that I've had problems with them running out of batteries, and then it's sitting there for weeks or over a month where it's not taking pictures because it's such a far walk from parking areas that I can't go check it often, and it's just basically they would just be useless. But with this trail camera, I have a spot in mind that I want to put it that I know I'm not going to be able to go to often, but now I won't have to worry about it running out of battery. I know it's going to sit there and be able to just soak for months and be taking pictures the entire time. So that's a spot on public land, like I said, far walk in, and a spot that I only might be able to go check it a couple times a season, and I'm not gonna have to worry about it running out of battery. So that's gonna be a huge help for me. So I'm excited to get it out there this fall and continue using it. Like I said, if you guys are interested in the camera, I would definitely recommend it. I have the link down here in the description, and thank you guys for watching, and as always, we will catch you guys on the next video.